Tinsel and lights and the presents are nice, but the real gift is you. Happy birthday, Jesus. I'm so glad it's Christmas. All the carols and bells make the holiday swell, and it's all about you. Happy birthday, Jesus. Jesus, I love you.
And the prayer. Christmas time is a time for office parties and dinner parties and family get-togethers and so forth and so on. Our nation has already begun this frenzy of activity, and it'll continue until the new year, so much of it losing the true meaning of the season and the reason we can celebrate it at all. Can you imagine for just a moment what a difference each one of us could make if we choose to celebrate this holy time by truly worshiping and honoring God and Jesus Christ with our lives and our influence? Could it be that even you, just one of you, could make a difference in someone's holiday season by celebrating the child who is the light of the world?
Celebrate the child who is the light. Now the darkness is over. No more wandering in the night. Celebrate the child who is the light. Celebrate the child who is the light. Now the darkness is over. No more wandering in the night. Celebrate the child who is the light.
Opened my eyes. God has promised He will never leave us nor forsake us. In Christ, God has revealed His faithfulness to us from the beginning of time.
In Genesis, Jesus is the ram at Abraham's altar. In Exodus, He's the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, He's the high priest. In Numbers, He's the cloud by day and pillar of fire by night.
In Deuteronomy, He is the city of our refuge. In Joshua, He's the scarlet thread out Rahab's window. In Judges, He is our judge. In Ruth, He is our kinsman redeemer. In 1 and 2 Samuel, He's our trusted prophet.
And in Kings and Chronicles, He's our reigning king. In Ezra, He is our faithful scribe. In Nehemiah, He is the rebuilder of everything that is broken. And in Esther, He is the Mordecai, sitting faithful at the gate.
In Job, He's our Redeemer that ever liveth. In Psalms, He's my shepherd and I shall not want. In Proverbs and Ecclesiastes, He's our wisdom. And in the Song of Solomon, He's the beautiful bridegroom.
In Isaiah, He's the suffering servant. In Jeremiah and Lamentations, it is Jesus who is the weeping prophet. In Ezekiel, He's the wonderful four-faced man. And in Daniel, He's the fourth man in the midst of a fiery furnace.
In Hosea, He is my love that is forever faithful. In Joel, He baptizes us with the Holy Spirit. In Amos, He's our burden bearer. In Obadiah, our Savior. And in Jonah, He is the great foreign missionary that takes the Word of God into all of the world.
You go on and you see in Micah, He is the messenger with beautiful feet. In Nahum, He is the avenger. In Habakkuk, He is the watchman that is ever praying for revival. In Zephaniah, He is the Lord, mighty to save. In Haggai, He is the restorer of our lost heritage.
In Zechariah, He is our fountain. And in Malachi, He is the Son of Righteousness with healing in His wings.
In Matthew, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. In Mark, He is the miracle worker. In Luke, He's the Son of Man. And in John, He is the door by which every one of us must enter.
In Acts, He's the shining light that appears to Saul on the road to Damascus. In Romans, He's our justifier. In 1 Corinthians, our resurrection. And in 2 Corinthians, our sin bearer.
In Galatians, He redeems us from the law. In Ephesians, Jesus is our unsearchable riches. In Philippians, He supplies our every need. And in Colossians, He's the fullness of the Godhead bodily.
In 1 and 2 Thessalonians, he is our soon coming King. In 1 and 2 Timothy, he is the mediator between God and man. In Titus, he is our blessed hope. In Philemon, he is a friend that sticks closer than a brother. And in Hebrews, he's the blood of the everlasting covenant.
In James, it is the Lord that heals the sick. In 1 and 2 Peter, he is the chief shepherd. In 1, 2, and 3 John, it is Jesus who comes with the tenderness of love. In Jude, he is the Lord coming with 10,000 saints. And in Revelation, lift up your eyes, church, for your redemption draweth nigh. He is King of kings and Lord of lords.
Family here at First Baptist North Spartanburg, we proudly present the Twin Living Christmas Trees. We invite you to sit back, relax, and be our guest.
be our guest. Be our guest. We're here again, and it's the best. Wrap that scarf around your neck, my friend, and we will do the rest. Music's great, we can't wait. Gather round, you've got a date. Christmas Eve and all is happy. Light, sound, action, make it snappy. We will sing, write and rhyme. After all, it's Christmas time. And the program here is never second best. So open up your heart, give us a little part. Cause you're our guest, you're our guest, you're our guest.
Smiles galore, it's no chore. Joy and laughter, so much more.
We're prepared to serve with flair a lovely Christmas smorgasbord. You've all come, and that's great. And our music, it can't wait.
It's not gloomy or depressing.
When it's Christmas, we're addressing. We will sing, that's for sure. Just for you, Miss and Monsieur.
And it's all in perfect time that you will sing.
It is a night of flash. Got a special pass to be our guest.
If you're stressed, it's our program we suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
Life can be so stinging for a singer who's not singing. He's not whole without someone to hear his song. On most days you seem to be so useless. Then suddenly it's time to sing your song. All year long the voice is rusting, so it needs much more than dusting. It needs exercise and a chance to use its skill. Most days singing wears me to a frazzle. Fuzzy, fat, and lazy, then it's Christmas, whoops-a-daisy. And some guests, and more guests, sakes alive, and I'll be blessed.
Music scored, so thank the Lord, I've had the costumes freshly pressed.
We'll rehearse until we drop, then after hours we'll finally stop.
While the people are rehearsing,
it's my voice that I'll be nursing. I'll get warm, even hot. Goodness sakes, is this my spot?
Sing it up, we want the audience impressed. We've got a lot to do. Is it one verse or two for you, our guest? Nothing less.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Messiah's come, the one of whom you've read. And as he spoke to men that day, the heavenly host around the throne joined in to say, glory to God in the highest, peace on earth and goodwill to men. Heavenly angels announce his arrival in the little town of Bethlehem. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy, he was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God in the highest glory, hallelujah to the Lord, amen. Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, and goodwill to men. Heavenly angels announce his arrival in the little town of Bethlehem. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy, he was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God in the highest, 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 glory to God in
He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. This was the Son of God.